Hello and welcome to Las Vegas. My name is Michael Lehmann-Horn from Magic Multimedia. We are Grass Valley distributor. Behind me you can see the Las Vegas Convention Center. Tomorrow the NAB Show exhibition starts. And today, on Sunday, the manufacturers are presenting for the resellers and distributors their news, what they are going to present tomorrow. So we were able to take a first look into EDIUS 8.2 because this was presented as at the reseller event from Grass Valley today. We had the opportunity to already test EDIUS 8.2 and would like to invite you now to, together with us, take a close look into the new features of EDIUS 8.2. We will present these together with a Microsoft Surface Book, which is very light and ideal for EDIUS because of the latest Intel CPU processors with Intel QuickSync technology. So take a close look together with us. Have fun. New in EDIUS 8.2 is the motion tracker function. You'll find the motion tracker in the mask filter. You use the mask filter as usual. So you mark something in the picture. Here it is a logo. And then you use the tracking function to follow the logo and the motion of the logo. And now you're able to set a filter in this mask and hide, in this example, the logo, or to blur it. We use a mosaic filter so that the logo no longer can be seen in a proper way. Make it a little bit bigger. So you see before and after. And we could also do some blur. We even have the possibility to change the blur during the time by using keyframes. Or we can do color correction. So if we say, no, we want to use the logo, but we want to change the color, we can track it. And then we can use a color filter, so a three-way color correction, for example, and change over the time the color of the logo. So usually you would have to track the logo on your own, so you have to follow the motion of the logo to do this kind of effect. And here the tracking is very easily, it's done by EDIUS, and you can simply use keyframes to do this color adjustment. And you can use this mask filter with the motion tracker not only to hide something in the picture, you can also make it clearer. For example, the face of this man. We have selected the face, but now we use the outside filter and make the picture a little bit darker. And you see the difference is very, very visible. The face is much clearer and has a great appearance. We can also use more than just one filter outside, so we can use the combine filter and combine up to 5 filters at the same time. Of course, you can also use the combine filter once more, so you can combine as many filters as you like. Here we use a color correction. We adjust the brightness a little bit so that the outside area is darker, but we also use a blur effect. So we make a blur outside the face so that everything else than the face is getting masked in an unsharpened way. And for the face, so that's the inside filter, we use sharpness. So that the face is sharper than, much more sharper than the rest of the picture. we have done this here very clearly so that the difference is very, very easy to see. And this is a way you can do a really a professional color correction by using a tracker with the color functions which EDIUS provides. And as you probably know, there are many different filters inside EDIUS which allow you to adjust a picture. With EDIUS 8.2, there is one more filter for color effects, and that's the primary color correction. This color correction tool is a really very, very powerful color correction tool because it's not only adjusting colors, it's adjusting color spaces. So we see this example of two shots. One, both are done with a DVX200 from Panasonic, one with V-Log and one without. So the first one is without V-Log, it's a 709 color space. So if we select the primary color collection and put it on the clip, we see that the color correction of the source and of the project is 709. And if we make it darker or brighter, we see that it's under or overexposed. So there is no headroom for a big color correction. When we use now the primary color correction on the V-Log shot, you see that the V-Log shot in the beginning is very, very flat. We then select Panasonic V-Log. So if we select Panasonic V-Log as source color space, you see that, wow, there are the colors. And now we have the possibility to over and under expose. And when you under expose, you see the blue sky and the clouds in the sky. So you see there's much more information inside that picture than if you compared with a picture in 709 from the beginning. So you see the difference here. They're also visible in the details, but very good in the brighter areas like the sky. In one case, it's just white. In the otherwise, you have a sky with clouds. I have prepared a second clip. And this clip is recorded by a Canon camera in C-Log. So you see, if I select primary color correction and put it on this clip, it automatically will select Canon V-Log. And the colors are adjusted correctly. Of course, you still have the possibility to change all the values. And this is really a complex color correction filter. You have all the possibilities you usually have inside a grading tool. And even a YRGB curve is there. So you can adjust not only YOV like you could before, you can go in each color channel as well. And you can very exactly adjust the color settings. The adjustments are even done with numbers. So you have a curve, but at the same time, you can do adjustments by using numbers. And that's very important to save settings. So you can do your own looks and your own color correction. In the next example, I have a Sony S-Log 3 material, which can be corrected in the same way with the primary color correction. So I select S-Log 3 in the source. And now you see the colors are where they should be. But this file is a Sony RAW file. And you can see that if you go to the properties and the stream type, you see Sony RAW. So in EDIUS 8.2, also Sony RAW and Canon RAW is supported. But in some cases, using raw material in a EDIUS timeline will make the system slow, especially if you have a system which is not as powerful. So there is a possibility to reduce the resolution of the playback. You see it here, you can switch from full, which is in this case 10-bit, to 8-bit, or you can reduce the resolution, which is 4K, to the half, the quarter, or even a lower resolution. And by doing so, you have more real-time power, and you can use a system which is not as powerful for even editing 4K material. When you work with proxies, the source files are exchanged with low resolution files. When you work with this draft mode, you have the same source files, but you have a lower playback quality. It's important to know that this new draft mode is only available in EDIUS Workgroup 8.2. So it's not a part of EDIUS Pro. It's just the workgroup version who gets this functionality. But there is another thing which is new in EDIUS 8.2, and that's only for the Pro version. In EDIUS 8, there was a special functionality for the workgroup version, which is basically that you have the possibility to use more cores and CPUs than in the Pro version. So the workgroup version has more power on these systems. And with EDIUS 8.2, EDIUS Pro 8 gets the same functionality. So you will have more and a greater power, especially when encoding H.264, when you have 6, 8 or even more cores with hyper-threading in your systems. So this is a good thing for all EDIUS Pro 8 users, that they get this extra functionality. There's some more small, nice features which are included, but the ones which I have shown you are the main features. And I hope you are happy with this short presentation. And the version 8.2 will be available very soon on the 21st of April for download. And it's a free download for everybody who has purchased EDIUS 8. The resale event of Grass Valley gave us the opportunity to speak to Marco Lopez, the CEO of Grass Valley, about the importance of EDIUS.
Yeah, so when we were working on the due diligence right before the acquisition of Grass Valley, I was extremely excited by the prospects of having such a powerful nonlinear editing platform as part of our suite of products. My previous history was working for a company called Matrox. And Matrox, we always were bundling or working with companies like EDIUS, like Adobe, like others. And so having this as part of our strategy, our breadth of products, was really important to me.
And we also had the opportunity to speak to Takauchi-san, responsible for the EDIUS product line and located in Kobe, Japan. Also, we could speak to Steve Weiss, responsible for Grass Valley marketing. Dear Takauchi-san, we see here the room is full of resellers who are selling EDIUS and Grass Valley products. How are EDIUS sales worldwide?
Worldwide, EDIUS sales is really growing in Japan or in worldwide in 2015. It shows further growth in 2016.
And when you look at the sales numbers, are there a lot of news editors who are using EDIUS? How is it with creative people?
Creative people started catching up EDIUS for now. That's why we are adding more features for the creative people, such as motion tracking, color grading support, log support. Those are the features we are really focusing on the creative people.
And how important is EDIUS for Grass Valley?
EDIUS is very important for the Grass Valley and as a standalone editors, also the combination with the Strata systems, asset media asset management Strata system.
With me is Steve Weiss from Grass Valley Marketing, and we have seen there are some news about EDIUS 8.2 and also an announcement regarding hit film. What can you tell us about that?
Well, 8.2, as you've seen with the motion tracker and the primary RGB color correction, is really much more of a creative choices for the editors. And alongside this, we've been talking with HitFilm, who make a family of plugins called Ignite, and they've agreed to support Ignite natively, which is a great coup for us. So it really rounds out the EDIUS 8.2 offering.
So I see plugins are getting more important maybe to allow EDIUS even to reach other groups of users. Are there other plugin companies who are working on plugin for EDIUS?
Yep, we're talking to a few. I mean, obviously, from our point of view, we have the OFX bridge, which gives us access to more plugins than we had previously. But the best way of supporting plugins is natively. So, for example, we are talking to a couple of other people here at the show about supporting EDIUS natively with their plugins.